Hi, this is MC Shetty, and in this video I'm going to introduce a new feature in Ariente, a new upcoming feature, which is the automation field. It's this device. It's still very experimental, so there are still bugs and it's far from complete. Also, I still have to decide on a few things. First about Ariente. Ariente is a highly advanced techmod based on technology that you have to discover in another dimension. So we are now in another dimension. It features a dual power system. You see two, a Neckerite and a Poserite flux generator running here. And there are two cables bringing power to this machine, which is currently not using anything. So how does the automation field work? First, you set up the area where you want the automation to happen. So let's do it like this. Say, now let's open the user interface and trigger. So now you can see the area. If you can, you can toggle this on and off. So if you don't want to see the area, just toggle it off. And this I will explain later. So here you can set the height. So that's the height of the area that is being controlled by this automation field. But we set it to 3, that's good enough. So let's say we have, we'll use Ariente storages, that's nicer. But you can use any kind of storage. So let's make, do it like this. So here we have, oh, that's the wrong block. I need this storage. So that's a drawer storage cube from Ariente. And we will put, we will fill it with iron ore. And we will also fill it with coal, like that. Let's add another storage cube here. And here, that's our destination. So we have iron ore and coal that we want to convert to iron ingots, and for that we just use the regular old vanilla furnace, but we will place it in the middle of the automation field like this, because let's do it like this, make it a bit nicer. So the automation field can only do automation for things, for nodes that are inside the field. So this is our storage cube containing the materials we need to input into the furnace. So let's add an output item node there, and that will go to on one side. Hold on, let's make go up here. So we have input for the iron ore at the top. We have input for the coal at the side. And we have input, let's go down here, output I mean, at the bottom, like that. And then another input here. So to configure this, right click this, and that's a filter, and we say oh yeah, I need at least, oh yeah, that's stupid, I'm in creative, forgot about that. I need to protect that. Yeah, the popping that you hear is this door which keeps opening. Okay, let me get some iron ore back and some coal. Let me go to survival. First set to peaceful. Then I can access this one better. Yeah, now I have one. Okay, so this is output. We want to output iron ore and coal. You can toggle NBT damage and ore dictionary, but that's not needed here. And you can say the stack size that it needs to transfer. You just set it to 1 for now. So this is configured for output. This is input, this is a site, so that means our goal goes here. Okay. And our iron ore should go there. Let me try to. So now you see it working. So the coal and the iron ore goes there. So this animation is just a visual representation. It doesn't actually correspond to the transferring of items. And this one doesn't update apparently. Let's see, is that a visual glitch? Yeah, that's a visual glitch. I need to fix that. But basically the items are going away, they're just a visual glitch that it doesn't show. This one is for output, we need iron ingot. So let's take one and configure it. Double click. So you can remove it with that. And this one, input. And for now we have to, the automation field doesn't discover that something has changed, so that's also something that we need to fix. But normally, as soon as there is a narrow ingot, it's already there, but because it doesn't always render, it's just a visual representation. I probably need to increase the chance of it being rendered, otherwise you don't really see a lot. So there, because there's lots of items, you can see it there, but this one isn't showing. But yeah, you see it has been updated. These are also updated now. So basically that's the idea. Item transfer can be very fast. This one uses power while it is doing that, of course. So the speed at which items can transfer depends on how much power this one is getting. The actual animation is just something visual that doesn't really matter. You can disable the animation with that, and then it doesn't render anything on the client side. Slightly more efficient. So about the features, this one and this one. This may still change. Oh, it's currently rendering. Let's see. Oh, it's here. Yeah, 29 already. So it's working. I need to fix the auto update. And of course I will add more features. By the way, this is also multi-part. I could add another output node here. And actually I could, let's do that. Let's remove that one. And let's insert it here. And let's toggle an update. And normally the iron ingots should now go there. So you can have both output and input at the same position. Yeah, there it is. So it's a bit of a multi-part like system. There you could see the animation. So basically that's the new feature. I will also support nodes for power, both oriented type power like this, as well as RF power and also fluids. I'm not sure yet if I will add more advanced features. I can add extra pages, so like this. So these extra pages could be used to have more advanced features for item transfer, like keep at least minimum that amount, keep at least at most maximum that amount, and so on. But I'll see about that. Anyway, it's time to say goodbye now. Feedback is always welcome. I hope you enjoyed it. See you next time. Bye bye.